Hello student, good morning everyone. My name is Pratibha Sharma. Today I am going to discuss about the chapter cell, the unit of life. Okay, first everybody familiar with this word cell. Cell is the structural and functional unit of all the living organisms. First you have to know the difference between the living organism and the non-living organism. Living organism, there are so many properties that are shown by the living organism. Like living organism show growth, living organism reproduce, living organism excrete. Okay, there are so many functions. On the basis of this, we differentiate the living organism and the non-living organism. Suppose the non-living organism, they do not show the growth, they never reproduce, they never excrete. Okay, so first means the cell is the structural and functional unit of all the living organisms. Okay, like human body. Okay, the human body is consist of millions of cells. These cells are different in shape, size and their function. Okay, now this is the basic structure of the cell. The cell is basically consist of first the outer membrane. This is the structure of cell. The outer membrane, which is made up of cell membrane. Now first I'm writing, after that I'll explain you. Okay, second is cytoplasm. Third is nucleus. Fourth, cell organelles. This topic I am going to explain you in detail. First, the cell membrane. Cell membrane we also call plasma membrane. Okay, cell membrane we also call plasma membrane. The outermost membrane of the cell we call the plasma membrane. Now this is the plasma membrane. One cell wall is also present. Cell wall is also a outermost membrane. Now plasma membrane is like cell membrane, we also call the plasma membrane. The cell wall is also present. Okay, here again this cell, this is the nucleus. This is the plasma membrane, and the outermost layer of this plasma membrane we call cell wall. What is this cell wall? Cell wall is basically the outer membrane which is present in plant cell only. In animal cell, this plasma, this outermost cell wall is absent. Okay, now this is the structure of plant cell, and this is the structure of animal cell. Okay, understand? Now in animal cell, the outermost membrane is the plasma membrane. Now in the plant cell, the outermost membrane is a cell wall. Okay, you got the difference, Peter? On the basis of, you can differentiate this is the plant cell and this is the animal cell. Because in plant cell, the outermost membrane is the cell wall, but in the animal cell, the outermost membrane is the plasma membrane. Now this plasma membrane, I'll explain you in the detail. This plasma membrane is, this plasma membrane is basically made up of lipid and protein. Okay, this outermost membrane, the plasma membrane or cell membrane, which is consist of a substances, one is the lipid and the second is the protein. Okay, now you know about the, what is lipid? Lipid is basically a composition of, बेटा बेसिकली प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन डायग्राम के थ्रू शो कर देती हूँ. दिस इज द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. नाउ दिस इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, दिस प्लाज्मा, एक्सप्लेन यू, दिस इज द डायग्राम. Now this is the head part of the lipid. Beta, this is lipid. Basically, the plasma membrane is made up of bipolar or bilayer of lipid. Plasma membrane is made up of bilayer of lipid. Okay, this is the structure of lipid. One head is there and two tail is there. Okay, this head part is made up of phosphate. This head part is made up of phosphate and glycerol. Glycerol. And this tail part is made up of fatty acids. Fatty acid. Understand? Again, I will recall you. Okay. This pavilion, the outermost membrane of the plant cell is made up of plasma membrane. Okay. This plasma membrane is made up of lipid and protein. Okay. First, you know about the lipid. Lipid is basically the composition of three substances. One is the phosphate, second is glycerol, and third is the fatty acids. Okay. Basically, the structure of lipid in the plasma membrane is like this. One head is there and two tail is there. This head we also called hydrophilic. Hydrophilic. The head is hydrophilic and the tail is hydrophobic. Hydro means water. Okay. Now philic means water loving. And hydro means again water. Phobic means hater. What does it mean? Hydrophilic and hydrophobic means water loving, means they are able to absorb water. Okay. Now the hydrophilic means they are not able to absorb the water. This is the basic difference. Okay. Again, the plasma membrane, which is consist of lipid and protein. Lipid, this is the basic structure. Lipid is present in the plasma membrane. Beta, this is the structure of plasma membrane. Okay. Plasma membrane made up of lipid and protein. Okay. The one lipid structure is like this. One head is present, two tail is present. Head is made up of phosphate and glycerol and tail is made up of fatty acid. Okay. In the behavior or in the composition, you understand? Now, this is hydrophobic means, hydrophilic means they are able to absorb water. Means their head part is able to absorb the water. Now, the tail part is basically they hydrophobic in nature. Phobic means that they are loving, they don't easily absorb it. Understand? Now, what does, now again come to the protein part. Okay, now protein, beta, in between the plasma membrane, there are two type of proteins are present. First is, one protein is like this, and I'm using another color. Means, there are two type of proteins are present. Okay, now here, protein. Protein is of two type. First is peripheral protein and the second is intrinsic protein. Now, what is the function of protein? Because we know the cell membrane or the plasma membrane is made up of lipid and protein. Okay, the protein is of two type. First is peripheral protein and second is integral protein. Beta, what is the basically the function of the protein? Why it is here the peripheral protein? Peripheral means the outer membrane. The protein which is present on the outer membrane of this plasma membrane means the position of this protein is like this on the periphery. On the periphery, this is the peripheral protein. Okay, now intrinsic protein means jo dono layer ko jo cell membrane ki dono layer hai usko cover karti, that is intrinsic protein. Okay, now protein, first you understand the protein. Protein is basically a composition of amino acids. We also call protein, we also call polypeptide chain. Protein we also call polypeptide chain. Poly means many, peptide means hota hai amino acid, means there are so many amino acid like this. Poly means many amino acid. So many amino acid combined to form protein. Understand? Means protein is a composition of or chain of polypeptide. Okay? This you understand? Now peripheral, what is the function of this peripheral and this integral protein? Peripheral is basically is present on the periphery of the cell membrane. The function of this to maintain the distance, between two membrane of cell membrane, The function of this periphery, because the periphery protein, beta, this is present on the this membrane or present on this membrane. They are basically the function of this to maintain the distance between the two, this membrane of the plasma membrane. Understand? Now the second is intrinsic protein. The intrinsic protein, first you know the what is the function of this plasma membrane, because this plasma membrane is a part of cell. Okay, so what is exactly the function of this plasma membrane? This plasma membrane is basically functions help to maintain the substance movement of the substances from outside to inside. Okay, because this plasma membrane is the outermost membrane. Now this help in the movement of the substances in and out. Okay, now this is of also plasma membrane, you know, also of different type, like selective permeable membrane, semi-permeable membrane, permeable membrane. Permeable membrane means easily substances can move. Semi-permeable means only the required substances are move in and out of the cell. Okay, selective permeable means ho gaya, semi-permeable means hota hai, kuch substances jo hota hai, move kar jate, kuch move out ho jate, okay. Selective permeable membranes, the function of selective permeable membrane is to only select the substances which is required for the cell, okay, to do the function. So this plasma membrane is basically function is to help in the transport of substances like the intake of oxygen and exhale of the carbon dioxide. Again, intake of food and outtake of waste material. This is the function of plasma membrane. Okay. Now here the protein. Okay. This integral protein, the function of integral protein is the passage to movement of the substances from inside to outside. Means the substances which care substances beta iske through membrane ke through jahan pe lipids hote hain iske through only water absorb hota hai. Water can move from out to in, but the protein is the channel which helps the movement of the substances to move in and out. Jaise aapka room hota hai beta, room ke andar ek kya hota hai, door hota hai, us door se aap in or out hote hain. Same here the protein, the intrinsic protein function is to move the substances from that way only, from outside to inside. Okay, here means the substances will move inside and move outside. This is the basically function of this integral protein. Periphery protein only maintain the distance between the two membrane. Okay, now intrinsic protein is basically help in the transport of substances from outside to inside. You understand? Okay, beta. Okay, now the second is the cytoplasm. Second we'll study about the cytoplasm. The cell wall, also in the plant cell, the cell wall is the outermost membrane of the cell, individual cell. What is the function of this cell wall? Basically, first you know the difference between the plant cell and animal cell. Because the animal cell is that unka structure or unka function is tarike se hota hai kyunki animal move from one place to another to search their food. Okay, plant apni position pe ek position pe bhi stand karte hain. It means the cell wall is basically the give strength to the cell, plant cell. Okay, outermost membrane jo hai cell wall hoti hai wo ek usko jo hai rigid ek jo hai usko structure provide karta hai because plant cannot move from one place to another. Okay, for their food, they make their own food at the ek hi position pe rehte hain. Okay, this is the basic structure. Because cell wall jo hota hai beta wo ek plant cell ko ek rigid jo hai structure provide karta hai. Okay. Sorry. Now the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is basically the fluid substances which is present inside the cell membrane. This is the cytoplasm. Okay, cytoplasm jo hota hai, this is the fluid matrix, cytoplasm. We also call fluid matrix. Fluid matrix means the denser liquid. Okay, now the in the cytoplasm there are so many cell organelles present. In the cytoplasm there are so many cell organelles are present. Like endoplasmic reticulum, second mitochondria, third Golgi apparatus, fourth is lysosome. Okay, these are the basic structures or cell organelles which is present in the cell. Okay, the endoplasmic reticulum is basically a structure of like work as a cytoskeleton. Endoplasmic reticulum is function as a cytoskeleton. What does it does mean? Cyto means cytoplasm, skeleton means framework, frame. It work as a frame, means the endoplasmic reticulum is always arises from the nuclear membrane and extend up to the plasma cell membrane. Okay, this basically is provide the structure. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. It arises from the nucleus and ये सेल मेम्ब्रेन से अटैच्ड होता है. ये बेसिकली अगेन सेल टू स्केलेटन. स्केलेटन व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ स्केलेटन? नाउ अबाउट इट प्रोवाइड ए फंक्शन और इट गिव एक फ्रेम. इट प्रोवाइड अ फ्रेम टू द बॉडी. ओके, इज दिस ओके? द एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम इज अदर नेम इज साइटो स्केलेटन. मीन्स इट्स वर्क लाइक ए स्केलेटन और एक जाल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर जो होता है सेल के अंदर प्रेजेंट होता है. इट मेंटेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द न्यूक्लियस एंड द दिस cell membrane, because cell membranes are basically fluid mosaic. Fluid mosaic means they move like wave. Okay, so it maintain, kyunki kai bhi condition mein hoga ye kya tumne shape ko change kar sakta hai, but no, because of endoplasmic reticulum the it help to maintain a shape of the cell. Okay, the endoplasmic reticulum is endoplasmic reticulum is of two type. First is rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The name shows rough endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum means this is the structure of endoplasmic reticulum. Rough means they are beads like structure which is present on the bead like structure. The bead like structure beta which is present on here, the bead like structure which is present on this endoplasmic reticulum is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Because of presence of ribosomes na, the structure of the endoplasmic reticulum is just like a rough endoplasmic reticulum. This structure we called ribosomes. Ribosomes, which is present on rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now, what is the function of this ribosomes? This help in the synthesis of protein. This help in the synthesis of protein. And the rough endoplasm, this is small endoplasmic, there is no bead-like structure present on the smooth endoplasm. It means the structure of this endoplasmic reticulum is very smooth, roof, rough nahi hota. Rough kyun hota? Because of presence of ribosomes. Okay? And this is very smooth endoplasmic reticulum, means very, there is no rough. Okay? This smooth endoplasmic reticulum also help in the synthesis of lipid. Now you understand, this endoplasmic reticulum is basically maintain the structure of the cell, arises from the nucleus till the end of the this cell membrane. Okay, now endoplasmic reticulum is two type, rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is because this rough structure is ribosome, bead-like structure which is present on the endoplasmic reticulum is called ribosomes. The function of ribosomes is to synthesize protein. Now, this smooth endoplasmic reticulum, the function of this to synthesize protein. Now, this protein and lipid is used for the formation of this cell membrane. Okay? Is this okay, beta? Mitochondria now. Mitochondria is basically double layer membrane. This is the mitochondria is basically made up of two layered membrane. Okay, this is the structure of mitochondria. This is the outer membrane and this is infolding membrane, we call inner membrane. The outermost membrane again बॉडी को पूछे बाहर से कवर करने का काम करती है. नाउ द इंटरनल मेम्ब्रेन और द इनर मेम्ब्रेन आर प्रेजेंट इन इनफोल्डेड फॉर्म में, दैट वी कॉल्ड क्रिस्टी. दिस हेल्प इन टू इंक्रीज द सरफेस एरिया फॉर द सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन. डू यू नो द वर्ड सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन? Respiration is basically, beta, first you have to know the difference between breathing and respiration. Breathing is basically the exchange of gases, it's called breathing. Generally, हम उसको breathing को ही respiration बोलते हैं, but there is a difference between breathing and respiration. Breathing only means only inhale or exhale of the gases, okay? Breathing means only exchange of the gases, okay? Now, respiration is a process in which the food is oxidized and produce energy, okay? The first you know the difference, okay? Now, the cellular respiration means, the respiration process which is takes place in the cell is called cellular respiration. Now, in the cell ke andar jo cellular respiration hota hai, that is in only in mitochondria, okay? The inner membrane jo hota hai, iske andar fluid present hota hai, aur is fluid ke andar jo hota hai, the cellular respiration process jo hota hai, wo wahan pe perform karti hai. Is this okay? Now the Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus is basically consist of three types of structure present hote hain. First is cisternae, like this like structure. Some are present in vesicles form. Some are present in the tube like structure. Like this, okay. The Golgi apparatus is basically present in three forms, okay. First in the like vesicles forms mein hote hain, cisternae forms mein hote hain. Some vesicles like is tarah ki shape mein present hote hain, aur kuch ke andar jo hai wo is form mein present hote hain. Now basically what is the function of this Golgi apparatus? Golgi apparatus is the function of Golgi apparatus is to transport. Golgi apparatus is to transport substances which is formed by the endoplasmic reticulum. Transport and work as a transport substances and packaging substances. Means Golgi apparatus ka kaam kya hota hai? Is work as a transport and packaging. Jo substances bante hai, unko package karta hai, packing karta hai and transport from one place to another as according to their uses in the cell. Okay, the Golgi apparatus is basically the function of transport and packaging. What they transport, what they packaging. They transport and packaging the substances which is secreted by the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum synthesize protein. This protein and the lipid is transport. First उसको जो बनता है उसको पैकेज करते हैं ठीक है and then पैकेज करने के बाद उसको ट्रांसपोर्ट करने का काम करते हैं as requirement और as according to their uses. Understand बेटा? Golgi apparatus function is three types of cells present होती हैं, different shapes होते हैं उनके. The functions are same, but the shapes are or the in the cell they are found in three shapes. Okay. Now the basic function of this Golgi apparatus is to transport and packaging the substances which is synthesized in the cell. Basically the protein and lipid. Understand? Now the lysosome, the next or last one is the lysosome. Lysosome we also call suicidal bag. Why we call this suicidal bag? Because this, beta, first you know, this Golgi apparatus jo hota, it also form the lysosomes. Golgi apparatus jo hota, wo lysosome ko banane ka kaam karta hai. Lysosome is type of cell which is present in the cytoplasm. Okay, this lysosome is consist of hydrolytic enzyme. Okay, consist of this lysosome consist of a hydrolytic enzyme. Means the enzymes are very 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 harmful for the entire cell. Ye basically the function of this lysosome is as a scavenger. Scavenger क्या करते हैं? जो waste material होता है उसको clean करने का काम करते हैं. Okay? The same lysosome is also called suicidal bag क्योंकि इसके अंदर क्या होता है? बहुत सारे जो हैं वो digestive enzymes होते हैं. ये enzymes जो होते हैं वो क्या करते हैं? जो भी cell का waste होता है उसको decompose करने का काम करते हैं. ठीक है? अब suppose this cell is burst. In emergency, अगर ये cell burst हो जाती है, पूरी blast हो जाएगी, तो क्या होगा? ये enzymes क्या होते हैं? Itself पूरे spread हो जाते हैं, और पूरे cell organelles को itself जो होता है, वो अपनी cell को जो है, वो खत्म कर देते हैं. That's why we call this lysosome suicidal bag. Okay? Okay? Nucleus. Nucleus is basically present in the center. Okay, this outer membrane we call nuclear membrane. Okay, now nuclear membrane में इतना continuous कुछ इसके अंदर spaces होते हैं. Continuous नहीं होती जैसे मैं बना रही हूँ यहाँ पे कुछ spaces होते हैं because for the exchange of substances. Okay, completely जो है वो surrounded ही होती है. Some spaces, some pores are there that we call nucleopores. Okay, that help in the movement of the substances in and out again. Okay, this nucleus is made up of a fluid that we call nucleoplasm. Okay, one nucleus, in nucleus one single nucleolus part is present. Here one small nucleolus is also present in the nucleus. This function of nucleolus is to help in the formation of rRNA ribosome, in the formation of rRNA. Okay, rRNA means ribonucleic acid. Means this nucleus nucleolus which is present in the nucleus help in the synthesis of the this ribosome ATP adenosine triphosphate. Okay, RNA, DNA. What is this? DNA. DNA is the deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA is the ribonucleic acid. This ribonucleic acid is basically help in the formation of the protein. Okay. This ribosome, this help in the formation of the protein. This RNA is present, is synthesized by this nucleoplasm. Okay. Now next is, what is DNA? DNA is basically the genetic material. DNA is the genetic material. What is this genetic material? Genetic material means it carry the genes or the traits, characters which transfer from one generation to another generation. Okay, the DNA is which is present in the nucleus. Okay, this DNA is the genetic material which transfer from one generation to another generation because it carry the genetic character of that species. Okay, now there is one chromosome is also there. What is the difference between chromosome and DNA? Let me explain you, beta. Chromosome and DNA. Okay, now chromosome, beta. This is the resting stage of the cell. The resting stage of the cell. This is active stage of the cell. But at the time of when, dekhiye, jab resting stage hoti hai, matlab there is no cell division. That the stage of the cell is the resting stage. Means at the time of resting stage, the chromatin material, the genetic character is present in the form of thread like this. This present in the. At the resting stage of the cell, the chromatin, the in the nucleus, the genetic material is present in the form of chromatin thread-like structure, like this structure. Okay, the resting stage hoti means resting stage means वहाँ पे cell division वाली stage नहीं है. उस time जो genetic character होता है, जो nucleus के अंदर present होता है, that is present in the thread-like structure, like this thread-like structure इसमें present होता है. Like this, but the at the time of active stage means they are ready to divide. At that time, the chromatin material condense to form chromosome. Condense to form chromosome. This is the structure of the chromosome. Okay, now at the time of active stage, the chromatin material condense to form chromosome. Okay, this chromosome is made up of like the beta, जैसे sweater होता है ना, sweater का thread निकालते हो, जब आप thread निकालो तो sweater खुल जाता है. Same ऐसे DNA को जब आप इसको खोलोगे तो क्या होगा? The DNA is consist of a DNA and protein. Understand? Chromatin material. When the cell is in the resting stage and the active stage, the chromatin material condenses to form chromosome. Okay, this chromosome is made up of DNA and protein. Okay, cell organelles I already explained you. Okay, thank you.